किसी ना किसी रूप से। तो सैटेलाइट जिसमें हमारा बहुत अहम रोल अदा करता है, अगर हम किसी देश को अभी किसी मान लेते किसी देश की अगर सैटेलाइट से उसकी कनेक्शन भंग हो जाए, टूट जाए, छूट जाए, तो कल्पना कर सकते हैं कि उस देश की एक भी टेक्नोलॉजी सही से काम नहीं कर पाएगी। आज हमारा कोरोना काल में भी देखे तो हमारा जितने भी ये सैटेलाइट का रोल रहा, जो भी हम सूचनाएं आदान प्रदान कर रहे थे, जो भी हमारे एप्स गवर्नमेंट ने जारी किया, दिशा निर्देश जारी किया, हमें बता रहा था कि ये आदमी ये व्यक्ति कोरोना से पॉजिटिव है, आप इनके संपर्क में आए हैं, तो वह हमारी कहीं ना कहीं रूप से वो सैटेलाइट से ही संबंधित है, स्पेस प्रोग्राम से ही संबंधित है। तो हम देखते हैं कि किसी भी रूप से अगर दुनिया में अपने आप में एक वर्चस्व स्थापित कर रहा है, तो आगे आने वाले दिन में एक हमारा स्पेस प्रोग्राम ही होगा। और जिस दुनिया में जो सबसे महान रोल अदा करने वाला है, जो दुनिया में शासन करने वाला है, और उसके बारे में हमारे जानकारी कुछ भी नहीं, हम आगे बढ़ने में लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, इंजीनियरिंग पढ़ रहे हैं, मेडिकल पढ़ रहे हैं, इंजीनियरिंग का एक भाग ही होगी, मैकेनिकल पढ़ रहे हैं, इलेक्ट्रिकल पढ़ रहे हैं, कंप्यूटर पढ़ रहे हैं, स्पेस को लेकर जो हमारा पूरी का पूरी कल हम निर्भरता उसी के ऊपर होने वाला है। तो सैटेलाइट एक हमारा बहुत उसमें बहुत महान रोल प्ले करने वाला है। तो सैटेलाइट पर की परिपक्वता जैसे जैसे बढ़ती जाएगी, वैसे वैसे इसकी सुरक्षा की भी जिम्मेदारी बढ़ेगी। आज हमारा भारत उन चुनिंदा देशों की कतार में खड़ा है जो देश अपनी धरती से स्पेस में सैटेलाइट को मार गिराने में सक्षम। एक समय था, सुरक्षा की दृष्टि से देखे तो एक समय था जब हम छल जल नभ से अपनी परिसीमाओं की रक्षा किया करते थे और आप बदलाव का अनुभव कर सकते, लेकिन कल एक समय आएगा जब हम इन समस्याओं का समाधान के लिए सरल और सटीकता के साथ अंतरिक्ष सहारा लेकर करें। इन छोटी बड़ी तथ्यों का विचार करें कि हम अंतरिक्ष के क्षेत्र में अपना वर्चस्व कैसे हासिल कर सकते हैं, स्पेस में सर्वश्रेष्ठ पहचान बनाने के लिए हमें किन किन संसाधनों की आवश्यकता हो सकती है, हमें अपना वर्चस्व को स्थापित करने के लिए सबसे पहले अपनी मानव संसाधन की सर्वश्रेष्ठ आवश्यकता है। इन मानव संसाधन में सर्वाधिक स्पेस साइंटिस्टों की आवश्यकता है। हम सोचे हमारे साइंटिस्ट कहाँ से हैं? अगर हम सोच के देखते हैं हमारे साइंटिस्ट कहाँ से हैं, तो भाई हमारा साइंटिस्ट तो आप ही लोग हैं, हमारे जो स्टूडेंट्स उपस्थित है जो सुन रहे हैं वही लोग हैं। आप सब में वो काबिलियत है, आप उस काम को अंजाम दे सकते हैं, आप वो सारे काम को अंजाम दे सकते हैं। कितने स्टूडेंट्स को यह अनुभव हो रहा होगा कि हम जो तो मैनेजमेंट कर रहे हैं, हम तो सिविल की पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं, हम तो फिजिक्स से ग्रेजुएट हैं, हम तो इसमें कोई रोल प्ले नहीं कर सकते। शायद आप जानते ही होंगे स्पेस कैरियर के प्रति संवेदनशीलता, आप अगर जान जाएगी तो आप सारा काम भी कर सकते, कोई नहीं कर सकता। उन्हें अपने क्षेत्रों में ये सिर्फ एक कार्यक्रम नहीं है जिसमें आप और प्ले कर सकते हैं, इसमें आप अपनी बहुत बड़ा जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटी बना।
सभी लोग एडमिट हो रहे हैं बट इसमें
तो अब एक चीज सोच सकते हैं, ये चेंज कैसे आएगी, हमारी ये परेशानी कैसे जब हम सारा काम कर सकते हैं, तो क्या कर सकते हैं और कैसे कर सकते हैं। इसमें कुछ लोगों की यहाँ तक ये मुसीबत भी है कि आज हम जो भी इंजीनियरिंग करने आए हैं, चाहे वो किसी फील्ड का हो, तो हमारी पहली प्राथमिकता होती है कि हम एक करियर को अपना एक सेट कर लें, एक जॉब ढूंढ लें, अच्छी खासी नौकरी ले ले। हमें तो ये अगर इस फील्ड में मुड़ते हैं, नज़दीकी कोई जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटी दिखता नहीं है, तो क्या हम इस फील्ड में नहीं जाएं? नहीं, आप शायद आपकी मुसीबत है, आपकी प्रॉब्लम है, आप नहीं जा सकते, लेकिन आप अपने आस पड़ोस के लोगों को, आप अपने छोटे बच्चों को उसके प्रति प्रेरित कर सकते हैं कि नहीं, आगे आने वाले दिनों में यही हमारा फ्यूचर बनने वाला है, आप इसी फील्ड में आगे बढ़ें। और ये भारत जो एक अपना बनाया है आत्मनिर्भर भारत का अभियान चलाया है, उसमें आप इसकी आत्मनिर्भरता को तो इन सारी परिकल्पनाओं का जो हम देखते हैं, और हम जब नीचे अपने युवाओं को जो हमारे भविष्य के साइंटिस्ट हैं उनको प्रेरित करते कि नहीं आप आए और इस काम को करें और करने के लिए प्रेरित हो, करने के लिए जब प्रेरित होंगे तभी वो इस फील्ड में अच्छी रुचि के साथ वो पढ़ाई करेंगे और पढ़ाई करेंगे तभी वो साइंटिस्ट बनेंगे। तो इन सब शब्दों के साथ हम
जितेंद्र जी धन्यवाद आपके मार्गदर्शन के लिए सभी बच्चों को। और मैं अब मानवी धवन जी आईआईटी बॉम्बे से जुड़ी हुई हमारे साथ प्रथम सैटेलाइट की की मेंबर, जिनका कंट्रीब्यूशन सैटेलाइट प्रथम में बहुत बड़ा है। और आप जो जानते हो कि प्रथम सैटेलाइट अभी स्पेस में है और आयनोस्फीयर में इलेक्ट्रॉन काउंट कर, तो उसके पीछे 8 साल की कड़ी मेहनत है। और वो इसरो के श्रीहरिकोटा सेंटर से PSLV-C35 से लॉन्च किया गया था। हम लोग आपको लॉन्च वीडियो भी दिखाएंगे। तो मैं मानवी जी से अनुरोध करता हूं कि प्लीज आप बच्चों को मार्गदर्शन करें। मानवी जी, यू कैन टेक इन हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश बोथ। यस,
हेलो,
हां मानवी जी बोलिए। यस मानवी जी,
जस्ट अ सेकंड, मैं अपना स्क्रीन शुरू करती हूं।
ओके, तो बच्चों मानवी जी का मैं एक छोटा सा, तब तक जब तक मानवी जी स्क्रीन शुरू करेंगे मैं थोड़ा और बताना चाहूँगा उनके बारे में। मानवी जी ने स्पेस साइंटिस्ट के रूप में बहुत काम किया और करीब इनकी 8 साल की मेहनत के कारण प्रथम अभी आयनोस्फीयर में है और मुझे लगता है कि आने वाले कई सालों तक वो रहेगा। तो साथ ही साथ उन्होंने कई सारे प्रोजेक्ट DRDO के लिए किए और उन्होंने बहुत मेहनत किया इसके पीछे, और अभी कई सारी मिसाइल सिस्टम पर उन्होंने काम किया है। तो आप सभी के लिए बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट डे फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू, that she is with all of us and she is going to deliver about how she has built the satellite and how it was difficult to do such kind of things for the country. And this, her speech will inspire all of you to make your own satellite. And after that, you have a great scientist from NASA who will give you the rest of the, you know, the rest of the sunny day. Yes, Manvi ji, please continue.
Thank you, Ravi ji, for the wonderful introduction. Good morning, very good morning to everyone, and it's great that you all are here on Saturday morning, and it clearly depicts that how enthusiastic and interested you all are to listen and to learn something new on this weekend. And I'm sure that after this workshop you will be delighted and you will be having your own dream in space. And let's get started. So what is, I will just start with what is IDYM is about. So Igniting Young Minds ki, if we talk about it, so we started this organization just to ensure that it's not that you cannot find the knowledge of space and satellites and rockets on Google, or there are many YouTube, there are many books to learn about them. But what is important that the question that lies in everyone's mind, that why we need to study, why we need to know about space, why do we need to know about satellites and rockets, right? What is so different, what is so curious, what is so special about space? So that question that we decided, the IDYM decided to answer for all of you, be it kids or the elders, that question need to be answered, and rest all you all can manage, we know that. So IDYM started with the same mission, and we thought that the igniting the dreams in the people, that is the most important thing, and learning will proceed after that. So we did lots of workshops in many states in India, and the list is too long. We have also went outside India, and soon we are going to have many workshops outside India as well. So that's about IDYM and IDYM journey in last few weeks and months. So I will start with a very simple example, which Jitendra ji also mentioned, that whatever you see around yourself is somewhere inspired by space and satellites and other inventions that were made in for space. So I will give you just an example, so maybe kids would be able to relate that. So the Uncle Chips packet or the packaging that you see around you, that was first discovered for the astronauts in space. So because when the astronauts started going in space, they thought that their food, the scientists on the ground felt that the food that they are carrying with them should not get spoiled, right? Because astronauts also need nutrition above there. So that is, it was also inspired by space. Like that we are talking on phone, we are having a internet connection, that is inspired by space. So there is many, 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 many things that are coming to us that is possible only because of space and satellites all around the Earth. So there is a very great saying by our the great scientist Albert Einstein, that the problems that you have, the mindset, the mind that created the problems on Earth, the same mind cannot solve that problem, right? I'm saying the same mind means the kind of knowledge that you have while you were creating the problem. You have to enhance your knowledge. You have to come above that when you are planning to solve it. So for example, you are stuck in a dense forest and you don't know where to go, right? You can't see the roots. So where would be the nearest village or something, right, to ask for help. But imagine a person or your a friend of yours who has a helicopter and who is surveying that jungle, that dark forest. He can tell you, he can help you that you should go on the north or east direction to find the help, right? So it simply means that if you are so much stuck in the problem, you won't be able to solve it. When you are stuck in it, you have to come out of it. You have to increase your knowledge to the next level. And the satellites help in the similar way. So the satellites observe the entire Earth from upside above, and it makes so easy for the scientists to know the root cause of the problems that are faced by humanity on Earth and how to solve it, right? And now I will start. So that was about why satellites and space is so much important. And now I will start that why it was important for me and other team members of Pratham. Pratham was the first student-made satellite of India. And it was launched by ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization, in 2016. And so why we started it? So all of us had a dream that we want. I'm sure you also must be having that dream that we want to roam around the world. We want to touch the sky, right? We all have that dream when we are kids. So, and this today I can say that maybe I haven't went around the world. I haven't touched the sky. Like I haven't gone beyond the sky, but I have made something, some product that is my satellite, which is going around the Earth in every 90 minutes. It is encircling the Earth every 90 minutes. And it has also gone beyond the sky. It's not just limited to sky. So that's why we call Pratham to be the journey of dreams, because it took the dream of all the kids, all the students of IIT Bombay with it and flew in the space. So that's a Pratham. And here I will just give a brief about what satellite is about and how is it made. In a very simple terms, as you can see on the screen, that it is a yellow color, golden color box kind of structure, right? That is the satellite, and that is Pratham. So satellites have different shapes and sizes. Our satellite, our Pratham, was a 30x30x30 centimeter cube, and it was layered in golden layer that is called insulating layer. And this is required, this is like we wear masks these days. In the similar manner, satellites also wear masks, right? Because they need to be protected from the harmful rays of sun, right? Because there are many rays, many particles in space which are harmful also. So that need to be protected. So that's why that yellow layer is there. The another thing that is very interesting, you can see solar panel, right? The black color solar panel. Like we also need energy the similar way satellite needs energy, right? and that energy comes from the sun, right? Is my screen visible to everyone? Can somebody confirm?
Screen is visible. Screen is visible. He is having network issue.
Okay.
Okay. देखो बच्चों मैं आप लोग से कहूंगा जिसको भी अगर नेटवर्क का स्क्रीन नहीं दिख रहा है मीटिंग से डिस्कनेक्ट हो जाओ और फिर से कनेक्ट हो जाओ स्क्रीन दिखेगा आपके नेटवर्क का इशू है ओके
ओके थैंक यू रवि जी
मैम दिख रहे हैं लेकिन मैम का स्क्रीन नहीं दिख रहा है
सर यहां पर स्क्रीन पूरी तरह से विजुअल है इफ यू वांट आई कैन सेंड द स्क्रीनशॉट आल्सो इट इज विद मी
ओके
बट क्या है ना कि जिसको भी स्क्रीन का प्रॉब्लम है वो क्या करो मीटिंग से डिस्कनेक्ट होके वापस कनेक्ट हो जाओगे अपने आप सॉल्व हो जाएगा प्रॉब्लम यस मानवी जी कंटिन्यू
ओके थैंक यू सो यू कैन सी द सोलर पैनल सो दैट इज अबाउट अ सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी फॉर द सैटेलाइट नाउ यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन देयर आर थ्री एंटीना काइंड ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर थ्री एंटीनास यू कैन सी थ्री लाइंस दैट आर कॉल्ड एंटीना दैट इज यूज्ड टू कम्युनिकेट बिटवीन अर्थ एंड द सैटेलाइट सो वंस अ सैटेलाइट इज लॉन्च्ड इन स्पेस यू नीड टू नो वेदर योर satellite is functioning or not properly it is not like that you are given so much of money of nation so much of time of your professor and college just to throw a stone in space right you don't want that you want that whenever your satellite is doing something you should know what it is doing whether it is giving a valuable data or not right so those antennas are like ears and mouth for the satellite and that is used to communicate to transmit signals now you might not see sensors it is very small on the screen it's in the corner of the sonar panel very small sensor is there it's like eye of the satellite so satellite needs to see whether it is pointing whether it is looking towards the earth or not so when we talk to each other we look at each other right so in the same way satellite needs to see towards the earth when it is communicating with earth when it is talking to earth scientist so that's why that sensor that eye helps to know whether satellite is pointing towards earth or not so like that satellite has eyes ears our satellite was not having legs but most of the satellites have legs which are generally scientific language those are called actuators that those are motors so there are various kinds of motors to see whether to rotate the satellite in such a way that it rightly points like that so that's the overview of the what satellite is made of and so many things are inside that box which you cannot see in the picture definitely the lots of electronic components and lots of processors who continuously take data around in the space and then make that data available in small bit of information and that information is sent to the earth through signal that signal is very very interesting thing that is called morse code in science but you can say that is kind of secret message if you have seen movie Razi so Alia Bhatt gives a secret message from Pakistan to India so that's a secret kind of message which very specialized people know how to decode it and know that it belongs to that where it should be so that's a secret kind of message and it's very interesting things going around the satellite we will definitely can talk it will keep on we can keep on talking on that but yeah that's a wholesome so a very important question is why did we start it I told you that we had our dreams but the first person who thought that in India also students should also think that they need to make their own satellite that person name was Saptarishi Bandyopadhyay so he was IIT Bombay aerospace engineering student who once went to a conference just like that and there in that conference some Japanese professor came to that conference and he was talking about that how students in Japan made the satellite and he became so much sad from inside that in students in Japan and other nations are making satellite why not in India why haven't anybody thought about it so that trigger that why not we that made his mind that we can also make it he was not having any knowledge of satellite let me tell you very frankly before he decided that like we all are discussing, he was the same person. But that question is what ignited his dream, that why not we make that satellite? And then the journey started. He thought about it. He discussed his idea with professor. He discussed his idea with couple of friends. Some of his friends make fun of him. Some of the others thought that I should join his team and build this together. So like that, slowly the team grew bigger, right? And like every project, satellite also had its vision and mission. Vision means a bigger goal which we see generally, and mission is like a smaller aim of that project. So the mission of the Pratham satellite was to count electrons in ionosphere. Those counting actually helps in lot of scientific experiments. One of them is it also helps sometimes in tsunami prediction. That is very good cause. So in that way, that was a mission of Pratham satellite, to count the ions. And vision was a bigger goal, which we can say for Pratham, entire Pratham team, was that whatever we learn today while making a satellite, we should not keep that knowledge with us only. We should spread that knowledge to all the people. So like I'm doing today, we have done so many workshops. We actually did a workshop for Bhopal, in college in Bhopal, and they made their own satellite. So that's a great feeling which comes when you teach others what you have done. So that was the mission. So what makes this satellite and space thing so difficult? We talk about, right, that when we see something difficult, we talk about it's a rocket science, right? So why is it difficult? Let me tell you very frankly, the knowledge that goes behind it, the physics, chemistry, maths, biology, anything, any field of science that goes behind it, that is not difficult. That comes from your books only. That comes from your education only. What makes it difficult is the level of quality, precision, and professionalism that you need to maintain. So it's not like a regular project that you do on Earth, right? In Earth, if something goes bad, like you are making a small car of your own, if something goes bad, if it is not working, you go and again try to rectify the problem. But it cannot happen in space, right? You are working on your satellite, and once it is launched in space, you cannot send an astronaut to correct that problem. It is very costly to send an astronaut, and it's clearly stupid in this era, right? So that's why that quality, that 100% surety is very important in space, that whatever you are making, it is going to work 100%. You must have known that why ISRO is given so much value, because in the first attempt, they launched Mangalyaan and Mangalyaan was successful, right? So that's a good thing about ISRO. So that's how the space people, the scientists, NASA, ISRO, and every space agency work, that we need to learn from them. So that's what makes any space project so difficult, because you have to be 100% perfect whatever you do. You don't want to commit mistakes from your end. Now, like failure can be there in some form, but you should not commit mistakes from your end, right? Any kind of recklessness should not be there. That is the professionalism you need to maintain. And the most important part now I'll talk about is not the project, not the satellite, the people that make it. So just to give you an example, you will be able to relate that when there is a one group who has the brilliant students, but they don't have kind of bonding or attachment or any kind of better communication between them. And there is another group who are the average kind of students. They know how to do the hard work. They are good in terms of behavior and communication. You will definitely say yes for team B, the second group, because although they are average, that group, but they know how to do the hard work. They know how to learn and how to communicate with each other in the better way, how to work as a team. And that team will make your project successful. So that's what, when we were also taking students in our team, we were always keeping that in mind. We may not take the a person who has secured first position in his class, but we will ensure that how this person behaves with other people. That is very important. So people fail not project was this line was quoted by one of the team leader of Pratham, and it was a golden line for us, for all of us. And yeah, I talked about professionalism. So apart from it, the perseverance, you whatever you are doing today, you have to do it many, many times. And it's not just a week project or a 1 month project. It was a project of 8 years. 8 years, just imagine, you have to be dedicated to one single cause. You are doing something from early morning till late night. And every single day, I'll tell you our schedule. We used to wake up in 7 a.m. in the morning, attend our college classes, and after that, till 2 a.m. at night, we used to work. So that was a kind of schedule. And I'm not saying it was a schedule of only me. It was a schedule of entire team and for 8 years. So that's a kind of perseverance that you require. And that will come when you dream it yourself, right? So yeah, we talked about it, and this is that guy, that person who started this project, Saptarishi Bandyopadhyay. He is currently a scientist in JPL, NASA, and he's you can see how brilliant he is. He can so earlier in his school days, in college days also, he was very much interested in astronomy and other science Olympiads, and he was. He has won many gold medals for that as well. So he was brilliant always. And I wouldn't say that he was a born star, but he knew how hard work can result in continuous learning, and you can keep growing on that. So, yeah, and you can see there are 7 other team members, team leaders after that. So after Saptarishi, there were 7 team leaders, and under those 7 team leaders, there were many, around 40-50 people always working for the Pratham satellite. So yeah, the satellite finally took off with making a first step towards infinity. Why we say it a first step towards infinity, guys? Because it was not like we stopped dreaming after that. Every single person in our team, they got their first step, and they know that now they are not going to stop. They will rock the world. They will go wherever they go. They know what is the capability of having dreaming and having doing it with the help of their hard work. They knew it, and I'm sure that who all are in touch right now in our Pratham team, everyone is rocking in their industry. Somebody is earning amazing. Somebody is trying to innovate new things in their life. Somebody is scientist already, I told you. Somebody is trying to make a company around rockets. So they are doing amazing things. So just dream it and keep going, keep growing like that. Yeah, Raviji, shall we play a launching video here?
Play aap kar de, nahi to main yahan se kar dunga. Aap hi log kar dena. अच्छा ठीक है ओके ओके। तो बच्चों, अभी मैं आप लोग को लॉन्चिंग वीडियो दिखाऊंगा। ये जो रॉकेट जो आप देखेंगे, ये जो है वो PSLV C-35 है, जो कि PSLV आप सभी जानते हो कि ये 4 स्टेज रॉकेट है, जिसमें 2 सॉलिड प्रोपल्शन होता है और 1 लिक्विड प्रोपल्शन, 2 लिक्विड प्रोपल्शन होता है। तो स्वप्निल जी, आपको स्क्रीन दिख रहा है ना?
यस यस रवि जी।
अच्छा ठीक, ओके ठीक, ओके ओके।
Aircraft. The remaining 2 satellites, Pratham from IIT Bombay and PISAT from PES University Bangalore, are from India. The main objective of Pratham is to estimate the total electron count, TEC, with a resolution of 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer.
Have a feel of the launch.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
प्रक्षेपण ज्वलन बिल्कुल सामान्य आकाश की ओर उठता हुआ पीएसएलवी और जोरदार
वी विल हियर द कंफर्मेशन ऑफ द सेपरेशन ऑफ द प्रथम सैटेलाइट built by students of IIT Mumbai and also followed just 10 seconds later the separation of PISAT satellite built by the students of PES University Bangalore.
Ji haan, वैसे कई उपग्रह इसरो भारतीय विश्वविद्यालय के लिए छोड़ जी हाँ
या लगता हमें कतरे
था कि प्रथम ही सेपरेटेड और प्रथम सेपरेट हो गया और आपको आपके मन में एक डाउट होगा कि पीएसएलवी काम कैसे करता है तो आपको मैं एक छोटा सा एनिमेशन दिखाऊंगा जिससे आपको समझ में आएगा कि किस तरह से पीएसएलवी काम करती है तो आप लोग ये एनिमेशन जरूर देखें मैं अभी प्रेजेंट कर रहा हूं सो यू कैन वॉच दिस इज अ स्मॉल वीडियो एनिमेशंस सो यू विल अंडरस्टैंड हाउ दिस लॉन्चिंग ऑफ पीएसएलवी वर्क्स सो देयर इज अ डिफरेंट पार्ट्स आर देयर देयर इज अ बूस्टर पार्ट इज देयर There will be separation of different parts. You can just watch it. If you have any doubt, you can message us. We will answer this. Okay. So now I think screen is visible to all of you. Manvi ji, screen dikh raha na?
Yes, Ravi ji.
India's PSLV C2 rocket is standing majestically on the launch pad at the Sriharikota range, ready to be launched. First stage and the four grounded strap-on boosters are ignited. PSLV is getting lifted off and clears the launch pad. Two airlit strap-on boosters are ignited. Four grounded strap-on boosters are burnt out and are separated. Two airlit strap-on boosters are separated. First stage is burnt out and separated. Second stage is ignited. Payload fairings are separated. The second stage is now burnt out and separated. Third stage is ignited. Third stage is burnt out and is separated. Fourth stage is ignited. Fourth stage is burnt out and the main satellite is separated. Three micro satellites are separated.
यहाँ पर कि किस तरह से सैटेलाइट का सेपरेशन होता है और किस तरह से डिफरेंट स्टेज में बूस्टर कैसे इग्नाइट होता है उसके बाद डिफरेंट स्टेजेस होते हैं सैटेलाइट जो होता है सबसे ऊपर वाले पोर्शन पर होता है जैसा मानवी जी ने आपको बताया तो यस मानवी जी प्लीज कंटिन्यू
यस रवि जी यस रवि जी सो यस एवरीबॉडी सो दैट्स हाउ आवर ड्रीम ऑफ हेलो यस
तो बच्चों आप लोग कहीं जाओ मत अभी अभी नासा के स्वप्निल जी भी जुड़े हुए हैं मानवी जी के ठीक तुरंत बाद वो एड्रेस करेंगे ठीक है
यस यस सो
मानवी जी आप बोलिए
या थैंक यू रवि जी सो दैट्स हाउ आवर ड्रीम टुक ऑफ एंड डेफिनेटली आफ्टर द लॉन्च वी गॉट लॉट्स ऑफ रिकॉग्निशन नॉट ओनली इन इंडिया बट आल्सो आउट ऑफ इंडिया मेनी यूनिवर्सिटीज इन चाइना एंड अदर नेशंस कॉल्ड अस एंड discussed our experiences, our learning from the entire project. And it was a great feeling when you represent your nation there and you discuss with their space scientists whatever you have done. And I will share you one last story about the Pratham satellite and then we can end. So the thing is, we always feel that whenever we do something for so long, the end and we have put our entire hard work in that, our heart and soul, everything in that, we should definitely get success, right? We will always feel that everything should flow smoothly. But it never happens, I think, like that. There will always be something which is planned by God for you that you make you learn that you have to always keep fighting, right? So that's the story about after the launch. Like I told you earlier, the satellite needs to send a secret message, that signal towards Earth, and we need to know that whether satellite is working properly or not. And when the satellite is launched in the morning, we were waiting in the evening when it will come above Mumbai. We were in IIT Mumbai, and it will come above Mumbai and we will receive those signals. We waited for nearly half an hour during that window and we couldn't receive the signal. And it was like a complete shock for us, because the happiness that we were experiencing from the morning, 9 a.m. after the launch, it suddenly vanished from our lives. So all of us, the entire team, our seniors who have already graduated from the college, who are sitting in the US and other parts of the world, they were also very much shocked that how could satellite not send a signal? It means that, because in science, it means that you have put something which is equivalent to a stone. It's not working, right? And your hard work of entire 8 years was in vain. And suddenly, so that was a great feeling of like a loss, but we felt that we started troubleshooting on the ground, since we cannot do anything on that light, it's already launched. So we started troubleshooting on the ground, what went wrong with the ground station, the station which received the signal, what is happening with the weather, because weather also plays an important role. If there is so much clouds, then the signals get weak. So there are so many factors that means that anything can go wrong. A small cable, if it is loose, you cannot get the signal. And there are so many cables coming, right? So we started troubleshooting. We were trying so many things. We were trying to analyze what could have went wrong with the satellite in space. Maybe satellite was not switched on. Maybe satellite solar panel got hit by something else. So we were like coming up with random ideas, and we are trying to do the processing. We didn't sleep that night, I can tell you, and the entire team was working. And the next day we were called by governor. So you can see on the bottom picture, there is a picture with governor. So we were called by governor to greet us, and all of the team, in general, we should feel happy, right? But we knew that although Governor Sir, Honorable Governor called us, but this is the matter, this is a serious matter, and we were not feeling happy from inside. So this bus that you see on the picture, that has an interesting story. In that bus, this is called IIT Bombay Tum Tum. So we were in that bus, the team went to Governor's house, and while returning back from the Governor's house, a person from London, University College London, messaged us, one of our friends, that we received something from, I think it is from Pratham, please try to decode it. And then you can imagine, in the Mumbai traffic, we were trying to download that file in the mobile. We were not having laptops during that time in the bus. So we were trying to download that file in the mobile, and the communication, the girl who was handling the communication part of the satellite, she was so much talented after so many years of hard work, that just by listening that sound, she didn't need any other equipment. Just by listening that sound, when we played it after download, she confirmed that it is from the Pratham satellite. And you can see on that window, when later on we decoded it in the software, you can see in between there is a Pratham IIT Bombay student satellite is written, right? So yeah, so after that happiness, then again a downfall came in our life. We were all like complete shock, and then again it went up, and it was a happy ending. So that's what I meant, that it may happen that something is not working, but you should not lose your hope. You should keep trying, and if you have given your full, you have given your heart and soul in something, it will work. It will work in some or the other form, and it will give you returns. So that's a final saying from my side, and I would like to end here. Thank you so much. Keep dreaming, keep growing. Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Manviji, for your kind speech, and now I, as you can see on the screen, that Pratham satellite team leader Ratnesh Mishra, also he is the president of Igniting Dream of Young Minds. That organization is registered under Government of India. So he is receiving the, he is getting facilitated by the current ISRO chairman, that is K.C. Bansal, as you can see in the picture. So it's a great moment for all of you. You have got a chance to get addressed by a young scientist. You may have seen a scientist with big hair, age of 50 years, 40 years, but you might not have seen a scientist having age of 22 years and 25 years. And this is what you can see on the screen. Ratnesh is looking around 22, 23, and Manviji also not much. So it's a great thing for all of you that in the age of this, you are able to get such address by such a great people. Now I am taking you to USA. We are with us, Swapnil ji. He is very exciting personality, and he has been addressing so many workshops, not only in India, more than 60 or 70 workshops in outside India. Lot of things he has done for the welfare of the people. He is doing lot of things every day, and he is also mentor of Igniting Dream of Young Minds. So I request Swapnil ji to please unmute yourself and take the charge. Yes, Swapnil ji.
Sure. Yeah. Thank you so much, Raviji. And I will speak both in Hindi and English. And so to start with, I'll just bring about the presentation.
स्वप्निल जी के जब तक स्वप्निल जी का प्रेजेंटेशन चालू होगा उसके पहले मैं आपको उनके बारे में बताना चाहूंगा कि उन्होंने नासा के लिए बहुत सारे काम किए और इनका एक सपना है कि भारत में हर बच्चे को स्पेस के बारे में बताया जाए और हर एक जो बच्चा है वो स्पेस के क्षेत्र में काम करे. एज यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन अभी ये बहुत कुछ बताने वाले हैं. इन्हें दो बार भारतीय राष्ट्रपति से, भारत के राष्ट्रपति से सम्मान भी प्राप्त हो चुका है. तो आप लोगों के लिए बहुत बड़ा दिन है कि आपके सामने रत्नेश जी भी यहाँ पर प्रेजेंट थे और वो एक्चुअली वो बोल नहीं पा रहे थे क्योंकि उन्हें प्रेजेंटेशन कर रहे थे. वो भी एक बहुत ही ग्रेट साइंटिस्ट हैं. तो आपको मानवी जी, रत्नेश जी और स्वप्निल जी, तीन बहुत ही बड़े साइंटिस्ट से बात करने का मौका मिला है. बड़ा दिन है आप लोगों के लिए. यस स्वप्निल जी, कंटिन्यू.
ओके, थैंक यू सो मच. सो ये सेशन को इंटरेस्टिंग करने के लिए टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ द सेशन I would like to address a very interesting topic. हम जब बाकी workshops में भी करते हैं, कभी कभी क्या होता है कि when we are listening too much if of a speaker or of a presentation, तो हमें like एक 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 अलसीपन, you know, we get kind of bored or tired. So इसको interesting करने के लिए I would like all of you to think right now on a very interesting topic. कि according to all of you, आप लोग को लगता है कि are there aliens existing or not? So just write whatever you think about the presence of aliens right now in the universe. Aap comment box mein likhiye, and towards the end I will address this topic ki aliens hote hai ki nahi hote, like do the aliens exist or not. So that towards the end I will address the topic. To start with, Manvi ji ne bhi ye address kiya hai ki why it's important to address failures, and she has quoted a very beautiful line that it's not the project that fails, it's the people. So from that statement we can understand that it's all upon us, the amount of hard work we put in and the amount of efforts we put in. So keeping that in mind, it's very important to understand what's our end goal. Abhi hum Saturday morning mein we have joined together for a workshop, for a I would say a platform to share thoughts and ideas and expressions and our long-term vision and mission that we have. But individually, all of us have certain goals and aspirations in life. So it's very important that we understand the value of it, and we should have a very big goal. We should not be lenient in having a short term goal, or you know, like we should not be like lazy in dreaming big. We should have a big dream. So I would probably talk more about a very specific area of space technology that's called moon buggy or space vehicles. So let's assume that after the satellite part is covered, after we have developed wonderful satellites, we have reached to the surface of Moon and Mars and other planets, we would also require vehicles to drive on the planet surface. Like on Earth, we know that we have two-wheeler, like bicycle, like motorcycle, two-wheeler vehicles, four-wheelers, and other trucks, buses, and everything. Aeroplanes, we have you know, like boats. But what about the surface of the Moon? As we proceed towards the surface of other planets, we have come across that in the Apollo 15, 16, and 17, the first concept of space vehicle was introduced. So as you can see on the screen, this was one of the first space vehicle, electronical and operated ones that was used. But there were a lot of difficulties with this particular vehicle because the running capacity of this vehicle had been not more than 6 hours. It cannot drive for more than 6 hours. That means you have to go about 3 hours from point A to point B, and again you have to come back from point B to point A in the same duration of 6 hours. And if the surface is not that smooth, then the vehicle consumes more energy in the same given amount of time. So then, after like going about the research and giving a lot of thoughts on how to have a different model of space vehicle, it so came to the mind that why don't we design something that is manually operated? Like we all know that the bicycles are manually operated, so there is no need of like electricity, there is no need of diesel power or engine power engines. So in that case, if we can design something that is like manually operated, and it can be useful in many aspects, you know, we will the astronauts themselves will have the power to devise the length of distance they travel while they're on the surface. So me and my team, I was given assigned a team of around 10-20 members from different parts of the world. And my project leader was, his name was Ralph Hackel, and he's from Germany. So we were given the assignment of designing a space vehicle that can be operated on the surface of Moon. So as you can see, this photograph resembles a wheel of the vehicle, because on the surface of the Moon, the problem is if there is a tube, the wheel that has air inside it. So if there is a puncture that happens, it's very difficult to go about and refill and repair that puncture. So we came out with carbon fibered wheels that can also act as shock absorbers. Because as you can see the previous videos that was shown, the satellite cannot have much of equipments being stored inside. So it has to have something, a sort of vehicle, which will be having less amount of space occupied by itself, by the virtue of its design. And it should be lightweighted, and it should have multifunctions in the same compact vehicle design. So this wheel acted as a wheel, plus it also has less chances of getting damaged because carbon fiber is very elastic and it's long lasting and durable. Plus it also acts as a shock absorber. So it has two options or functionalities in the same or component. So as you can see, we are working, and as you can see, I'm there with the notepad and my teammates are there. So we are designing on the seat part, and we thought about why don't we design something that has two astronauts or space enthusiasts being sitting there and can operate simultaneously the same vehicle. So that, because the gravity on the planet of Moon, on the surface of Moon, is very less. It's 1/6 of Earth. So it has to have more muscle power. So we had, as you can see, there are two paddles there and a line so that two astronauts can sit on the same vehicle. So, and this is some random photographs from the space island in Germany. And so this is, as you can see on the screen, this is the vehicle that my team designed, and it has provision for two astronauts to sit on the same surface. So while astronauts are sitting on the same surface, It has a spokes drive and it has 14 gears, 14 different types of gears that can be operated at the same time. And it is designed in such a compact manner that the weight of this whole vehicle is less than 100 kilograms. It has components made out of carbon fiber to make it very lightweight. And it has axles and gears fitted in such a position that the two astronauts can have the same amount of energy. And if let's assume that one of the astronauts is tired by any means while operating this device, then the other one who is sitting in the back or the front, vice versa, can operate and put in the manual power required for this operation. So this photograph, this was during my pilot training in the coastal area of Germany. And we were given pilot training because when we prepare for being an astronaut, we have to understand that besides being an expertise in certain area of, I would say, electrical or mechanical or engineering field, you also should have equal amount of physical strength because the gravity in space is going to be nil, like it's like almost negligible. And then it also has a lot of effects on your psychological and physiological aspects of your body. So you have to have the strength, muscular strength, the stamina, and you should have a lot of stress management capability, because there are times when as I was driving the plane, it was just on the surface of the earth. I knew that I'm going to come back to the helicopter range and I'm going to land at some point. But as I was there on the sky, we are also made aware that the flight, the plane might malfunction, and there we might have to evacuate the flight at any moment from mid sky as well. So there are situations that might happen. But what about when the whole spacecraft is in the space? We will have no option of going elsewhere. So that's the only home and that's the only rescuer that we have. So if we panic at that moment, it's going to be very difficult for any one of us to handle that scenario. So while the training was given to us, while we were working on the projects of the space vehicle, while we were given a training of the flight, we also have to understand that we have to be academically expert, but 50% of that other aspect goes into your mental building strength. It's not related much to your IQ, I would say. It can be built up definitely, but you have to have a lot of mental exercises being laid out, a lot of physical exercises being carried out. And I mean, that's a journey altogether, which is very holistic. It's a wholesome experience that you can get. So my daily routine was in the morning would be to go on trainings. And we had some Olympians, trainers who trained Olympic level athletes. They were there along with us. They used to train us in the morning, and they had very interesting and exciting ways of training us in the morning. And thereafter, in the afternoon, we had theory classes. In the night shift, we used to go for some practical and like analysis and computer analysis, modulations being made. And on the weekends, we used to go on like the actual building of the project. So the whole lifestyle is very, I would say, productive. And we are made to understand the value of time and time management. These are two important aspects that we can learn. In the photograph, you can see along with me, there is Mr. Ralph Hackel. He's from Germany, basically, and he's the outreach manager for US NASA's main branch. So he was my project guide, and next to him, you can see me, and on the other hand, you can see his wife, who works for the Russian space agency. So it's very, this photograph is a very dynamic, I would say, because Ralph Hackel, he works for the NASA's program, and his wife, who works for the Russian space agency, and it's a very unique family. And you can see photographs at the back of his uncle, who was the first director of International Space Station. So when the International Space Station first was operational in the space, not far from the moon, in somewhere in between moon and earth, so his uncle was there looking after the project, and now he has taken over with all these projects, and he coordinates a lot of events and other things with from the Asian part, from the European part. And in the long run, he also will be coming on board, and I would like to share with Raviji also. I'm talking to Ralph Hackel as well to be on board of our advisory team, and we'll have a lot of direct reach to the NASA's core team. so that they can guide us and we can have a lot of fruitful discussions and you know, like events coming up and workshops coming up. So just to for one of the programs I would like to show, and I would go around a bit of the value part at the end. And these are two of my awards which I got. On the left side you can see I got the Ignite Award by late Dr. Abhijit Abdul Kalam for my innovation for especially gifted people, because I'm also an innovator besides being into the space field, and I'm also into the business aspect. So I have multiple areas of expertise or passion, I would say, that I'm exploring right now. And on the right side, you can see I was a part of Residence House in Residence program for being an innovation scholar in 2016. If we go back and understand what Manviji shared on her journey, there was a lot of talk about the passion and professionalism that she mentioned. And I would like to address this, because it's not possible for all of us in 1 or 2 hour session to give you the technical know-how of the things. But with my experience, I realized that there is a point where we have to be realistic with our decisions. We cannot be always going on a professional aspect, because that makes us dull and that makes us someone with a low motivation, I would say. And if we cannot be too much on the passionate part also, we have to be very realistic at times. So there are at times when my students, they ask me, sir, I like dancing, should I go for it or not? You know, and I like to sing, can I go for it or not? Same in the case, if you are thinking to be in the space domain, if you are thinking to be in the space technology, astronomy, you know, like other astrophysics area of like studies, which is not difficult to get in, I would say, but then again, it's very like it's going to be very tough for you to get into the area that is like less explored, because the whole space is like a huge, like I cannot define it by words, a huge segment, and we are just dealing with maybe 0.00 something percent of the segment. So to study the other aspect, the other remaining part, it's going to be a huge journey to unfold. So at times you have to understand that, do you have the I would say, to be very honestly, do you have the financial means to go on areas like this? Because to go and try to be an astronaut is going to cost you a lot for a training and everything. It's not going to be free at all. But then again, there are scholarship schemes available. There are NGOs and foundations that can fund you. If you are top of the batch, definitely you can go for that. So yeah, once you are planning that, once you are sure that you would like to go for space technology in the long run, you have to understand that, do you have any financial burden or any family burden that's with you? Because at times that may also hamper your pace of action. And if you do not have any of these aspects, then probably you can you know, like move on to the actual studies. And there are a lot of institutions in India right now as well, which, I mean, I think the later aspects, we can have some manuals and booklets that we can share with all of you, giving a brief thorough blueprint of which institutions in India are dealing with which area of subject and which area of studies, so that you can directly try preparing for those organizations. And if you want to try being an astronaut or in the space technology aspect in ISRO itself, what are the steps that you can take? So that you have to think about. But then again, on the other hand, I think if you're passionate about space, you might not take this as a profession. You might just take it as a passionate space itself. For me, I like alien hunting. So I have a group of people, I would say a secret group of people, who are dealing with all this space technology. But besides that, they are also into like the alien aspect, UFO. When I was in the US, when I was in the German land, I had a lot of friends being met there. And they're very secretive, like interesting organizations that are into the space alien exploration, I would say. So that's a passion for me. So you can also explore space technology as a passion for you. You can read about it. There are a lot of websites available, and still quench your thirst for it. Right. Before ending, I would like to share 4 key values that will actually help you in the long run. May not be in the field exactly. I would say it's not much preparing you for to be an astronaut, but something that can actually help you in life. And I thought that this is a good platform that you should take with you once we end the session. And the values, I would say, is that personal brand, the way you project yourself in front of a third person, second person, intellectual curiosity. You should not always waste time or invest time in always being curious, but you should know where to put in your time and energy. Empathy. The third value I always like to talk about it a lot. Empathy is basically putting yourself in other shoes and understanding, like, you know, what the problem is and what the situation the other person is facing. Because in a team, empathy plays a very important role, because as a team leader, you have to understand the capabilities and the potential of your teammates. And as a teammate, you have to understand the vision of the leader that you have, and social sustainability. So this basically is on the part where the contribution comes in of your project. So if you are doing and spending a huge amount of time, energy, and your own efforts for a particular project, how much of it is going to help the human society? So that also has to be kept in mind. So these are the four key values. If you are there, you might take a screenshot, I would say, because it's not going to only help you in space technology, but it's also going to help you a lot in your personal endeavors that you have, personal aspirations, even to start a business. This might come in handy for all of you. And just ending the session by this quote, stay hungry, stay foolish. And as we all know that this is a quote that's given by Steve Jobs. And I think we are running a lot of out of time, I believe. So I would end from my segment. And I would also put out my Instagram handle. So anyone of you who would like to have any personal questions can, you know, like, put in over there. So thank you, Raviji. I think I'm done.
Yes, Swapnil, yeah. It was a great talk by you. And I can see in the message box, the temperature was very high, although it is a month of November ending. And it was a temperature was increasing. The students were very excited, as well as the student, as well as the teachers who are involved in this workshop. It was a very great talk by you. Now I request Denu Lasmi from Tamil Nadu. Are you connected, Denu? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please. Yeah, proceed.
A warm and graceful note to our most valued Manvi Dhawan ma'am, Swapnil Talukdar sir, Jitendra Kumar sir, Ravishankar Kumar sir, Igniting Dreams of Young Minds Foundation, International Center of Excellence in Engineering and Management, worthy teachers, my dear friends, and everyone gather here. It's my privilege to propose an oath of thanks and acknowledge the contribution of those who work really hard to make this workshop on satellite technology event for us. First of all, extend my most sincere thanks to Almighty God for making today's event a resounding success. With His blessings and grace, we are able to make this event what it was. And our Igniting Dreams of Young Minds main aim is to promote space and satellite education for every Young Minds, that is for the entire student community from any schools and colleges all around the world. We involve a group of people with several years of experience in education, ranging from people of education ministry, various school principals and college principals, and talented enthusiastic. Igniting Dreams of Young Minds performs workshops, lectures on space and satellite for schools and colleges with distinguished speakers from multiple IITs, ISRO scientists, and many such space experts. I'm short of words. Last but not least, a big thank to each and every one of you who made this workshop joyful with their impressive explanation on satellite technology, are enjoyed by each and every one of us. On here, behalf of Igniting Dreams of Young Minds, I extend really a hearty oath of thanks to everyone. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And not only ISRO and the IITs, we have a scientist from DRDO. Recently, there was a workshop in West Bengal in IIT Kharagpur. We are one of the DRDO scientists. She addressed to us, and she's also part of the team. And we have a scientist, as you can see in the screen itself, NASA, from NASA, Swapnil Talukdarji. A various platform like BARC also, we do have a scientist. So this is the what we are doing is that we are working on Atmanirbhar Bharat, and we are trying to extend the, you know, space technology knowledge to all the people around the country, around the world. Because as all of you know that in this corona crisis, country was in lockdown, and during the lockdown, we were not connected with anyone, right? But what was making us to connect it to each other? That was the satellite. So that's why this workshop we are conducting to some student can come up and take the initiative. Yes, we will build satellite for India. You have a great expert with us, and they will help you to build the satellite. There is no such issues. Now I request some of the college authorities, if you want to say share your experience about the workshop, please unmute yourself and say yes. Okay, anyone from college side, you want to speak?
Hello.
Yes sir. Himan sir,
it was a very nice session. It was very nice webinar, sir. Thank you on behalf of International Center of Excellence in Engineering and Management. A very hearty vote of thanks for you, for Ravi Shankar ji to conduct this webinar, for your valuable guidance and motivation. When I click to your profile on Facebook profile, I got that your name is Ravi Don, and your lines are very nice there. Love your nation, love your institution, and love your profession. It is very impressive, sir. Thank you once again. Then I extend my sincere thanks to the entire team of IDYM, Manvi ji, then Jitendra ji, Swapnil ji, Anushka ji, and Dinul ji. Dinul, ask me, ma'am. So I extend my sincere gratitude to all the participants for their presence for this webinar on behalf of ICM. Thank you once again, IDYM team. It was a very nice and enjoyable session.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir. And I request all the students to please unmute your mic. Everyone unmute your mic. And in one word, you have to say Bharat Mata Ki Jai. Sab log apne apne mic on kijiye. Aur ek baar mein boliye Bharat Mata Ki Jai.
Bharat Mata Ki Jai.
Bharat Mata Ki Jai.
Yes. Yes, तो मैं रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा मानवी जी और स्वप्निल जी को इस सेशन को एंड करें यहां पर. स्वप्निल जी और हेमंत सर, कैन वी क्लोज द सेशन?
यस सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच.
यस यस, स्वप्निल जी, कैन वी क्लोज द सेशन? मानवी जी, कैन यू हियर मी?
यस यस, वी कैन कंक्लूड द सेशन. यस,
ओके ओके. तो बच्चों, जब भी आप मीटिंग लेफ्ट करोगे तो मीटिंग लेफ्ट करने के टाइम अपने माइक को म्यूट करना और बोलना भारत माता की जय और लेफ्ट हो जाना, या जय हिंद जय भारत बोल के आप मीटिंग लेफ्ट हो सकते हो. यस बच्चों, स्टार्ट राइट नाउ. 3 2 1 गो.
भारत माता की जय.
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 भारत माता की.
आवाज़ भारत.